Hello and welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a CMM 711. I have here a IC697 CMM 711 communications coprocessor. And just give you an indication of these LEDs here. First is OK LED port 1, if you're using port 1 and port 2. That refers to the two ports here, 1 and 2, also indicated by this door card. And then to give you more information about the rest of what you see here, this is an IC697 CHS 750 5 slot rack. From left to right, power supply is an IC697 PWR 711, and processor we're using is a IC697 CPX 772. And the rest of the slots are empty. This is just a test on the CMM. Now, you should normally have an OK light on pretty early with this particular module. If you don't, then there's likely a problem with the CMM, and that's something that we typically look at here. We offer repairs, an exchange program, new and remanufactured products, and we could do same day shipping. So if that is something that you need, please keep us in mind, pdfsupply.com. So we're gonna go ahead and run this test. What I've done in Prophecy Machine Edition is I've set up a configuration that matches what you see here with all these modules. And I've set it up right now to read RS-232 port. And that's a configuration that you can do. And once that's set, that's both on port 1 and port 2 under interface. Once that's set, you want to go to target, online commands, clear. And you want to clear controller fault and table and I/O fault table, nothing else. And then download and run that configuration. When it asks you what you want to download, just configuration and logic. It's the top two selections. So once that's done, I have to open up a program that we use called TestCom. So what I'll do is I'll hit the online offline icon, which is the lightning bolt, and so that I can detach the computer from the processor. Go to File and hit Exit. So now I'm going to close out of Prophecy Machine Edition, and I'm going to open what we have here called TestCom. TestCom is for GE FANUC PLC Communications Testing. And then on the bottom left-hand side, I'm going to go to a CCM type protocol. And what this does, this is kind of like pinging an Ethernet, but what there is there's a signal exchange between this software and the computer and the CMM. In order to get that signal over to the CMM, I'm going to be using this shielded cable. I'm sure you're all familiar with if you're testing this device. This end goes to the computer, obviously. And this end, set up for port 1 RS-232, is going to go to the CMM. So once that's properly connected, I'm going to plug my other end into the computer. And then I'm going to hit that port with this information by clicking a button that says Try All. Okay, and immediately I have a response. That's good. Then I'm going to put it onto port number 2. Once that's securely on there, I'm going to go ahead and hit Try All again. That's good. Okay, so now once that's done, what I would typically do is power the system down, go back in and reload the same configuration, except where it comes to the protocol, with the interface, I want to switch ports 1 and ports 2 to read the RS-422, as you see here, which would be the, or RS-485, I should say, the signal, which is the other side, the other port, and make sure that it can read at that value as well. So again, if you do have any problem, if you try to attach a signal to this and it doesn't respond, then you do have a problem with the CMM, and it's something that we look at here very commonly. We offer a repairs exchange program, new and remanufactured units, and if that interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. I hope this has been helpful. Thank you.